quite a while. I've been really wanting to share some practical knowledge about making art, but yeah, things happen and things get in the way. So let's get started. We're gonna do some watercoloring now. This is the beginner's tutorial, so we'll take it slow and go through a bunch of steps and what you need to know and need to have. The most important thing you need to have to do watercoloring is watercolors. Here we have Daler and Rowney. I actually just realized that most of my stuff is Daler and Rowney, even though I have not been planning to buy it all from the same brand, but it just so happened that I have it. Other brands are fine. I also have some White Knights from St. Petersburg here. Looks like this. These are also awesome watercolors, but whatever you have, it's probably fine if you're starting up. I also have a cheap set. Yeah, I have a lot of stuff. I don't even know what this one is, but it's a little bit less colorful, but it's also really nice to use. Then you need some water, obviously. I have a really nice cup here with some water, and like with most cups, and most clothes, for that matter, if you have it around when you paint, then they all eventually become painting cups or painting clothes. So then you need brushes. The most important thing about a brush is that it has to be soft, because then it will absorb some water and it's like just nice. It's just nice against your skin. So have one of those. And of course you need paper. I have an A5, 160 grams, it looks like this, or, yeah, I don't know, I'm filming it upside down, I'm not sure if I something, be like, oh no, I didn't mean it. I'll take it back, because you can't. You don't have any white. You can't put any white colors over the dark areas. So you usually start with the lightest bits, and you kind of cover everything or parts of it, and then you just get darker and more intense as you progress through your drawing or painting, whatever. You have to decide on your source of light, because that will dictate which parts of different objects will be lighter and darker, the shadows, the contrast. So let's just say we have our light source here, put a little X mark like in this area that way, and all our shadows will be kind of pointing this in this direction from the trees or whatever. And we will begin some water, put some lots of water on the brush, and just put some water on your paper. Actually, sometimes, or most of the times, you tape your paper to a piece of like a wooden palette instead of the table. But because I'm filming this and I don't want to move too much around, because then I'll get out of focus or outside of the camera, I just went ahead and taped it to the table. But I don't know what the difference is. Maybe you can just tape it to the table if you don't have a wooden palette or tablet or whatever. And then we have some yellow. It's actually quite yellow. And we'll put some yellow. Maybe this will be a hill. I don't know yet. I haven't decided that, which is maybe not very good, because I have to make some sort of landscape in my head. But we'll just go with it and see how it works out. Sometimes people draw their picture with a pencil, and then go around with it or kind of color it with watercolors. But I don't like pencil strokes on paper when you look at a watercolor drawing, so I'm not gonna do that. But you can do that. I mean, it's your drawing. You decide how you want to paint. I can't tell you what to do. I'm just here with some advice. Have some yellow, have some a little bit less yellow. I don't know, the sky, if it's so bright, will it even be visible? Maybe we can like make a tiny corner that's blue. And make it go out here. A little bit of blue, a lot of yellow. Yeah, and that just took no time at all. And you can see like it bulges out here, and because it's really wet. Yeah, that's what happens. And it's actually a really thin layer of paint, but this is what you have to do when you do watercolors. You just do really thin layers and you let them dry forever. And let's let this dry for a little bit. And we're back. You can see the color or the light has changed, because this has been drying for a while and I've been doing something else. I've been drawing. Usually I do watercolors while in between doing other stuff, because it takes hours and hours to dry, and I don't even remember what I was drawing here. This is why it's good to make sketches. But anyway, let's go on and make a landscape happen. And now what we've done so far is we have a sort of mild layer of paint, and now we want to add something more to it to maybe indicate like, oh, this is maybe a forest or something. second layer